Morning class. In the previous video, we have done the periodic table, that how Moseley has given his long form of the periodic table. Now we will move further. As I've told you that in periodic table there are 18 groups and 7 periods, and it is divided into 4 blocks, that is S block, which contains 2 groups, group 1 and 2, and P block, which contains group number 13 to 18, that is 6 groups. D block, which contains 10 groups, that is 3 to 12, and F block. Now we will see that how the Moseley has decided that in which period how many groups or how many elements can accommodate. As you can see here very clearly, in period number 1 there are only 2 elements, in period number 2 there are 8, in 3 also 8, in 4 and 5 there are 18 elements, and in 6 and 7 there are 32 elements. So in terms of electronic structure of the atom, a period constitutes a series of elements whose atoms have the same number of electronic shells or the principal quantum number. Thus, the period indicates the value of n for the outermost or valence shell of the atom of the elements. Means whatever will be the number of period, that will be the value of n, that is principal energy level. If n is equal to 1, it means we are talking about first period. If n is equal to 2, we are talking about second period, or vice versa. If I am saying second period, it means the value of n will be 2 here. If I am saying 4 period, it means the value of n will be 4 here. There are 7 periods, and each period starts with a different principal quantum number. Now we will see this. In first period there are only 2 elements, that is hydrogen atomic number 1 and helium atomic number 2. The first period corresponds to n equal 1, and when there is n equal 1, this is not surprising because first energy shell has only one orbital, that is 1s, and 1s has only one orbital which can accommodate only 2 electrons. So this means that there can be only 2 elements in which 1 and 2 electrons are present in first energy level. So this period contains only 2 elements, that is hydrogen 1s1 and helium electronic configuration 1s2. So it means on the basis of electronic configuration, Moseley decided that in which periods how many elements can accommodate. Now move to second period. Second period contains 8 elements because here the value of n is 2. There are 4 orbitals, 1 of 2s and 3 of 2p. We know in s there is 1 orbital, and in p there are 3 orbitals. And in second period, when the value of n is equivalent to 2, we have only 2 subshells, that is s and p. So 4 orbitals we are having here, 1 of s and 3 of p. 4 multiplied by 2 means 8 electrons can accommodate. This is the reason that only 8 elements are present in the second period, that is from lithium atomic number 3, starting from atomic number 3, to neon, that is atomic number 10. Now just move to third period. In third period, corresponding to n equal 3, there are 9 orbitals. There are 9 orbitals in 3. Why? Because when the value of n is 3, there is d orbital also. So it means 1s, 3, 3p and 5 3d orbitals should be there. It means there are total 9 orbitals. But we know that from the energy level diagram which we people have studied in chapter 1, that 3d orbitals are higher in energy than 4s orbital. So consequently, first we fill 4s orbitals before 3d orbital. So hence in this period we are going to fill only 4 orbitals, that is 1 of s, that is 3s, and 3 of p, that is 3p. So total here also, again, because we are filling only 4 orbitals, so that is why only 8 electrons can accommodate, that is from sodium atomic number 11 to argon atomic number 18. I think you understood this very well, that here we are having d orbitals, but because we are not filling the d orbitals, as d orbital is at the higher energy level than 4s, that is why again there also we are filling only s and p orbital, that is 3s and 3p. That is why here also we are having 8 elements. Now move to the fourth period. The fourth period corresponding to n equal 4, involving the filling of 1 4s and 3 4p orbitals along with 1 3d orbital. When n was 3, we have not filled 3d because 3d was at higher energy level than 4s, but here we will fill 3d orbital also. In fourth period, when the value of n is 4, we are having 4d and 4f orbitals also, but 4f and 4d orbitals are at the higher energy level than 5s. That is why first we fill 5s. So in this period we are not going to mention about 4d and 4p. Here we will fill the electrons in 4s, 3d and 4p orbitals. So 1 orbital of s and 3 orbital of p and 5 orbitals of d. So total here we are having 9 orbitals, and 9 to the 18, it means 18 electrons can accommodate over here. So that is why in fourth period we are having 18 elements, starting from potassium atomic number 19 to krypton atomic number 36. These elements are called as transition elements. Okay, now in fifth period also, same as fourth period, here also we are having 18 elements, starting from rubidium atomic number 37 to xenon atomic number 54. Why? Because here also we are having 5s, we are filling 5s, 5p and 4d orbitals, though we have 5d and 5f orbital also over here, but 5d and 5f orbitals are at the higher energy level than 6s. So first we fill 6s, so that is why here we are not going to fill 5d and 5f. Here we will fill 5s, 1 orbital, 5p, 3 orbital, 4d, 5 orbitals. So total 9 orbitals and 18 electrons are accommodating over here. Now move to the 6th period. In 6th period, we are going to fill 6s, 5d, 4f and 3p orbitals. So total 16 orbitals we are going to fill here, because here the value of n is 6. We are having the other orbitals also, but here we will fill 6s, 5d, 4f and 6p orbital. This is according to the energy level diagram. If you will see in chapter 2, you can come to know about this. So here we are having 16 orbitals. So 16 to the 32, it means 32 elements we can accommodate over here. Students, you can see here right now in the periodic table there are only 18 elements. Why? Because where it is written LA, lanthanoid, that is not one element lanthanoid, that is actually the series of lanthanoids, where there are 10 elements. You can see there below that green ones. So 14 elements. So 14 and then 18, it will become 32. So 32 elements are accommodating here. Here we are having lanthanoid series also in between in the third period. So 32 elements are here, and this period starts from here we can see it is starting from cesium atomic number 55 and ends at radon, the atomic number 86. And these lanthanoid series are called as, these elements are called as inner transition elements, and this series is called as inner transition series. Then in 7th period also, same as the 6th period, we are having 7s, 5f, 6d and 7p orbital. That is 16 orbitals we are going to fill here. That is why 32 elements can accommodate here. Here we are having actinoid series, clear, in 3rd period, which contain 14 elements. So 18 elements are present in the upper periodic table and 14 elements are present below in lanthanoid series. So total 32 elements are accommodating in 7th period also, clear. And these elements are called as inner transition elements, and this series is called as inner transition series. So that is why on the basis of the electronic configuration, Moseley decided that in which period how many elements can accommodate, and according to that he has given the whole periodic table. And on the basis of that we can say that with the help of this we can extract the electronic configuration also of so many elements, like the elements which are present in S block, they all are having the electronic configuration of 1s1 and 2s1. The first group is having the electronic configuration of ns1 and second group is having the electronic configuration of ns2. In p block there are 6 groups having the electronic configuration of ns2 and nsp2 1 to 6, means 13 group is having the electronic configuration of ns2 np1, 14 ns2 np2, 15 ns2 np3, then 16 ns2 np4, and then 17 ns2 np5 and 18 ns2 np6. And in D block we are having the electronic configuration of 3D and 4D and 5D and 6D according to the period. And in F block we are having the electronic configuration of the last valence electron will go into 4F or 5F orbital. So how is decided that which element should go in which block? That depends upon the valence electron. If the valence electron is entering in the S subshell, so the element will go in S block. If the valence electron means the last electron, is entering into the P subshell, so the element he has placed in P block. If the last or the valence electron is going into D subshell, so he has placed that element in the D block. And if the last electron is going into the F subshell, so that element he has placed in F block. So that is why on the basis of that we are having this general electronic configuration also. First group is having the general electronic configuration of NS1, second group NS2, 13 group NS2 NP1, 14 group NS2 NP2, and you can see upper 2-1, NS1 and NS2, these belong to S block because the last electron is entering into S subshell, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, these all belong to the P block because the last or the valence electron is going into the P subshell. So in this way he has decided that in which block which electron should go and in which period how many electrons or elements can accommodate. Now we will see some properties of S, P, D and F block elements in short, because we are going to study about these elements in detail in the chapters. In 11th we are having one chapter S block elements and P block elements, and in 12th we are having chapters on D block elements and F block elements. But here I will tell you some little introduction, or you can say in brief I will tell you. First of all we will talk about S block. S block contains only two group, that is group 1 and group 2. In group 1 we are having the elements from hydrogen to francium, and in second group it starts from beryllium. Okay, you can see over here the electronic configuration of first group element, the general electronic configuration of first group element is NS1 and second group element is NS2, where N stands for, where N is representing the period. As the period will change, the value of N will also change. So these are called as alkali metals. Why they are called as alkali metals? Because when they dissolve in water, they form alkalis. The metals of these two groups are soft metals, so that is why they are having low melting and boiling points. They all are metals and having the tendency to lose the electron, so they are electropositive in nature and very reactive because they can lose the electron very easily. Their ionization energies are lowest in the period as compared to D block, P block and F block elements. Their ionization energies are very low. We will study about ionization energy in detail in this chapter only in further videos. They all are very good reducing agent because they have the tendency to lose the electron, to supply the electron. So they are good reducing agent. They have a character, they give the characteristic color to the flame. All the metals give different colors to the flame. Like when sodium, when burn into the flame, it gives yellow color. Potassium gives violet color. Lithium gives pink color. So in this way they give different colors to the flames. They mostly form ionic compounds. If we talk about the P block, so in P block we are having the group number 13 to 18, and the general electronic configuration is NS2 to NP1 to 6. Group 13 is called as boron family, group 14 is called as carbon family, 15 nitrogen family, 16 oxygen family, 17 halogen, and 18 noble elements or noble gases or inert gases. The general characteristics are that they consist metals, non-metals and metalloids. All three categories are present here, but mostly they are non-metals. When we move left to right, their non-metallic character increases And when we go from up to down, their metallic character increases. Their ionization enthalpies are higher than S block. They mostly form covalent compounds. Some of them show more than one oxidation state, or the valencies also, like lead, Pb, show two valencies or two oxidation states, that is plus 2 and plus 4. Students, you will study about this in detail also in future, that most of the elements, mostly the elements have only one oxidation state, but in this group, the elements present in this group have more than one oxidation states also, like lead, tin, they are having the oxidation states of plus 2 and plus 4. When we move from left to right, they are reducing nature, convert into oxidizing nature. So it means we can say that they are good oxidizing agents. Okay, now move to D block. D block elements are also called as transition elements. Why transition element? Because transition means change. So from there, the properties of elements going to change from S to P. That is why they are called as transition elements. Here you can see there are four periods. Fourth period elements are called as first transition series or 3D series. Fifth period elements are called as a second transition series or 4D series. Fifth, sixth period elements, third transition series or 5D series, so on. The general electronic configuration. Third period elements have the general electronic configuration of 4s 0 to 1, 3d 1 to 10. As the group will change, the value of 3d will also change. Clear? And here we are having 10 groups and 4 periods. Clear? These elements are generally metals. They are not generally, they are metals only, but they are heavy and hard metals. As compared to S block, they are heavy and hard. So as their melting points and boiling points, they have high melting and boiling points. Most of them are colored. As you know, copper is blue in color. So they form complex agents. Their compounds are generally paramagnetic in nature. We will study about paramagnetic also in detail in future. There, most of the metals like vanadium, iron, nickel, chromium, they are used as catalysts. Clear? Now, if we move to F block. In F block, they are called as inner transition elements. Their general electronic configuration is NS2, N-1, D0 to 2, N-2, F1 to 14. Here we are having the lanthanoid series and actinoid series. Their characteristics are same as D block, means they are also heavy and hard metals with the high melting and boiling points. They also form complex agent and they are mostly radioactive in nature. Okay. So, in this video, we will study up to here only. Thank you very much, everyone.